So my car, I had two errors. So this is the EGR valve for my Peugeot partner, 1.6 HDI. And it's so it bolts to the engine like that. That side is the engine. Here is the intercooler, and this is the EGR valve. So I've got two errors that the EGR valve is ticking. So roughly about on 35%. So I decided to take it off and give it a good clean. I mean, I've already cleaned it, but I'll show you. Well, it's fairly easy. You basically take the plastic thing off, so you access the mechanism that turns around. So I'll open it now, and then basically spray a carb cleaner or a EGR cleaner, and with a toothbrush or something with or something to clean it. But I used a toothbrush. So basically, I would take these three bolts off. And this will. So this is my replacement EGR valve. It's not really the original one, and it's a Haas EGR valve, and it's only roughly about 8 months old. So I don't know why it's giving problems. There wasn't much crud inside. There wasn't much carbon, but I cleaned it anyway. So we'll see how it goes. If it's again giving me problems, I'll probably buy a new one. So I already really cleaned it, so it will be rather clean, but I'll show you where there was quite a bit of crud on. Right, so take it out. So let's see that part first. So that's the EGR valve. So this opens and closes. So it's really clean. You can see how shiny it is. I've already cleaned it. Let's see if I can shine a torch or something. Yeah, although it looks pretty clean. But basically there is a like a channel that goes up, so this really lifts inside, and then it drops down. This was relatively dirty. There was quite a bit of carbon deposit. So so basically I sprayed EGR cleaner or carb cleaner, anything, and then clean it really like with a toothbrush. So it's pretty clean. So you can see the valve inside. I'm not too sure you can see the valve. Yeah, I don't really have three hands, so you can see it's moving. Maybe, probably not. You can see how it's moving. So I'm closing it, then opening. So you can see inside how it's moving. That's the valve. So it's pretty clean from that side. Again, let me if I can somehow with two hands. So now it's open and you can close it. Well, let me see if I can hold it. It's a bit tough with two hands. So that's closed and opened. Well, let's see. So, well, inside same thing, so it moves. So that's about it. So I really cleaned it quite well. And you can see you can't see any deposits inside. Well, I mean, it's a bit dirty, but it's not entirely. So the way to put it together is a bit. So there was a really good video. I'll post a link of a guy who I saw it from on YouTube, and it was really amazing. So I decided to do my own because just to be careful. So the other thing was that here. So that's the electronic part. So that moves them. This thing here, and this pin. And it's kind of on the spring, so it turns back And there is a, so this was quite crude here. I mean, there was a lot of carbon deposits. So I also cleaned this up. I tried not to spray around here, so just basically spray at the end. So the way to do this, so you position it like that, with this to the bottom. So this is to the top. So you can see this is to the top, and this is bottom. So top closed, open, closed, open. This can actually also move, so this also moves. So, but there is, once you move it, so it kind of stays really stable. And there is an O-ring here, so you have to be careful to be inside. And there is also a rubber O-ring on that side, so you have to be careful when you put it. So basically. So turn it around that side, like that. And then this needs to be, let me see how it was. It's that way. So let's see, so turn it that side. So that's, it's closed at the moment. So it's open at the moment, or that position. So let's see, like that. And then what you do, let me, show it. So basically you rotate this, you put it inside and rotate, so you put this inside and then rotate. Let me see. So yes, so basically you slide it like that with these two pins, so this goes like that over. And then you rotate it until it clicks into place, and so then when this clicks into place, this will be the this will be on the upper position. So then when this moves, so it will basically open it and close it, open, close, open, close. So basically you put it like that, and then when this turns, so it will be like that. So then we'll just open it, so slide down. So basically careful for the O-ring. So you put it like that, and then you basically, there is a slide, so you have to lift the slide, and there is these two metal things, and then you put it in place. That's about it. Slots in place, and then I'll just try to shine, really just open it slightly to see if the O-ring is in place, and this is the O-rings, so both in place. Because initially it was fairly down, I think this O-ring is pretty good, and that's about it. Then you put the bolts in, then slide in the car. So that's the cleaning. So I probably intend to, we'll see how it goes. If the two errors will disappear, I was stuck in 35%. We'll see. Otherwise, I'll probably have to buy a new one. They're a bit expensive. So hopefully that helps you to undo it and do it. Well, thank you for watching.